You was cleaning your bump with 3 stones because Allah was telling you to clean your bump with 3 stones.
I don't want respect, sir. I don't want respect. Those gentlemen who are putting my life in danger.
How? You're putting yourself in danger with your t-shirt. Look what you're taking. You're putting yourself in danger.
What is wrong with my t-shirt? So why did you wear that trousers? It makes me very uncomfortable. That trousers is causing me
stress. Well, you need to go spec savers then if this trousers is making you uncomfortable. Go spec savers.
You are causing me stress, sir.
Go spec savers and wear the right glasses. The police officers came to you, Hatun.
The
police just came to you and you just was rude to them. You was rude.
Of course, you're a rude woman,
Hatun.
Of course, I am.
Yeah? You're similar.
You're rude. You are rude to her.
Look, there are certain gentlemen here who made a cover on my desk.
You should be respectful.
Call on Jesus.
Call the Holy Ghost. Call the Holy Ghost, Hatun. With your rude little mouth.
Islam is seriously very dangerous ideology. If you are still Muslim today and you are telling me that you are Muslim, give it up. They are going to come for you. They are going to come for you one day. They are going after people. Followers of Islam.
Some Muslims.
Not some Muslims. Followers of Islam.
Like some Christianity.
Why are you Muslim, sir?
What brought the Christian white people to your country, Iraq? What brought them?
What brought them to Africa?
I'm not from Africa, sir.
No.
You are from Iraq.
I am not from Iraq, sir.
You are an Arabic speaking Christian.
I am Turkish Christian.
You are an Arabic speaking Christian.
Sir, let's deal with that. Why are you Muslim?
Why am I Muslim?
Yeah.
And you want me to answer this question?
Yeah. Why are you Muslim?
Yeah. You want me to ask to answer this question for you?
Yeah, why are
because I would like to become a Muslim.
Why?
I found my parents Muslims and I have studied Islam. And I taught Islam and Arabic in Cambridge University and Manchester University.
I have no doubt that
Islam is the best religion. And that Islam respects Christianity and Judaism.
Let's deal with your claims on Islam as the best religion.
If someone...
Just a moment. You said you taught in
you
Cambridge.
You are in London here.
You said you taught in Cambridge. How old are you? Are you over 50?
68.
68. As a 68 years old man, would you have sex with 9 years old child?
What?
As a 68 years old man, would you have sex with a child?
Sex with a child?
Normally the Catholics
are raping Christian children in the camp, this is something normal.
As a 68 years old man who is Muslim, who taught in Cambridge, would you have sex with a child?
With a child?
Yeah.
Me, myself?
Yes.
And you are asking me this question?
I'm asking you that question.
You know, I have never made sex with a child or with an underage person.
Would you have sex with a child?
This is something personal.
Would you have sex with a child?
Are you married?
It is not a personal. Are you married?
Are you married?
Muhammad had sex with her.
Are you married?
So you don't agree with that?
Are you married?
You
Are you married?
That's not your business.
Are you married? So when you ask me about a child sex, I will tell you. When I ask you, are you married? Have you ever made sex with someone?
That's not your business.
It's a moral
why?
Question.
Why? Sex with a child is a crime.
She asked me about something personal.
She's asking something personal.
I thought she is an intellectual. And something intellectual is me.
I didn't ask you. Did you get your
I know, I know.
I ask you, are you, would she have sex with a
Catholic?
Child?
She's not asking.
Are you Catholic?
No, I'm not Catholic.
Sir,
do you agree with what the Catholics are doing with
your
children in the church?
I want him to tell me, how do you feel
Haji, you need to speak
as someone who's 68 years old, yes, who never had sex with underage, how do you feel when your Prophet Muhammad, peace, police and FBI and child social service be upon him, had a sex with 9 years old child?
Okay.
How do you feel about it?
Okay. Huh? You said my Prophet must be flesh. Through the toilet.
I didn't say that.
No,
I said
this.
I said, first of all, I said, if you how do you feel when
no,
your prophet
no, you told me here before
China.
2 minutes that my prophet must be flushed through the toilet.
Yeah.
If
maybe.
You if you will say you are sorry and you will respect,
I'm not sorry, Muhammad.
According to
Muhammad
the law in this country, you must respect Muhammad.
Muhammad.
According
be
to the law, you must respect Muhammad.
I don't have to respect Muhammad.
According
that
to my conscience,
that's not my law. That is not my law.
That's not law in this country.
You are not allowed to use bad names against anyone.
Against anyone.
Why don't you tell this to Allah?
54 years old man had a sex
Muhammad,
with a child, and
why
you want to respect
he is,
that person?
Calling us
unacceptable.
A dog.
Unacceptable.
I will answer him.
Calling sir, answer my question.
I'll answer your question.
You told him young men you should be able to answer this
don't
question.
You accuse, why don't you accuse Allah first?
Okay, I will
accuse Allah first, then Muhammad, then Quran.
Don't run away from your question.
I will answer your question.
Okay.
Don't run away from my question.
You are a Christian.
Yes, I am a Christian.
And you became a Christian because a white man, the Christian white
my question
man,
was what? How does he feel when his prophet Christian? Had sex
no?
with a child?
Okay. Who said that?
Underage sex, 54 years old, and this gentleman preached and teached in Cambridge. He taught in Cambridge. He should know better. He should know better. Look, they even call him Haji. Answer my question. Your prophet had a sex with a child. What is your problem? What is your problem, sir? You don't have a problem that your prophet had sex with
your,
a child.
Your
you
country?
Have a problem.
Sir, sir.
I claim you
sir, listen carefully. Sir, listen carefully now. Sir, listen carefully.
Aisha
was 9 years old.
Which country are you from?
When Muhammad had sex with her.
Sudan.
Yes.
Sir, Sudan, people of Sudan, they were dying with hunger.
Yes.
With hunger, and they have nothing to eat, and they have nothing. They were not even a civilized people. When the white people went there, they were not even a civilized people. Your people. They were not civilized. They were not living a quality life there. So the white people went there. They teach you how to put a trouser.
Yes.
They teach you how to put a basket and jacket and this hat
and
these glasses. They teach you.
Yes.
You people in Sudan, you was cleaning your bump with 3 stones because Allah was telling you to clean your bump with 3 stones. The white people, they went there and they taught you to wash your bump, to wash your bump with water.
This is hadith.
It's all in hadith.
It is in hadith, sir.
It's in hadith.
It's in
hadith. You're not supposed to.
He wants water. Allah says stone. Muhammad says stone. He thinks. Stone doesn't do a good job.
Sir, 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 listen now. Listen. Let me give you some more information.
Why did you? Muslim or a bad Muslim?
Mr. Sudan. Mr. Sudan, let me give you some more information.
Don't say Mr. Sudan.
Mr. Sudan, let me give you some more information. About your country. About your country, Sudan. About your country, Sudan. Let me give you some more information.
What is your country?
So,
what is your country?
So, because.
You hate
because. Because
you look African.
You
look African.
You was living as a slave.
You was living as a slave.
Slave in your own country. Okay. In your own country. You were dying. You was dying in the hunger. Many children. Many children. They were dying while the women were.
Is it a good thing?
Huh?
Is it a good thing?
It's a bad thing.
Okay.
It's a bad thing. So if I go and teach you and tell you how to live a healthy life,
boom.
Healthy life.
Boom.
And if I go
boom.
And tell you
boom.
And to teach you
boom.
how to use water to clean your bum. Is it a bad thing?
Water.
Is it a bad thing?
Have you ever seen?
Yeah, it's a bad thing.
With water?
Never.
Never use water for your bum. For your
no.
Two. Number two.
Muhammad. Muhammad teach you.
This is a joke.
Muhammad teach you to clean your bum with the three stone.
In the river
with three stone.
Here,
you Muslim. You were cleaning your bum with three stone.
Messenger of Allah said,
for cleaning
yourself, you need three stones, none of them being dung.
What for what?
Three stones. Arabic is here. For cleaning yourself, you need three stones.
Three stones to wipe
yourself. Is that, do you think that's
no, that is not true.
Muhammad is telling you. Muhammad is telling you.
Come on.
Muhammad is telling you this.
Go to the Quran.
So Muhammad, go to the Quran.
Muhammad is telling you.
Muhammad, correct?
Muhammad, are you saying Muhammad is a false prophet?
Muhammad is a false prophet.
Yeah.
Do you believe me?
Yeah.
I'm defending Islam. And I will say Muhammad is a false prophet.
This hadith is from Muhammad. And from Allah. Muhammad is receiving every information from Allah.
So he's a prophet. Thank you.
So he's a prophet. He's giving you a wrong information.
He's telling you to clean
yourself.
He's
giving you a wrong information.
He's telling you to clean yourself.
And not
is that applicable?
According
to hadith. Yes, I'm not with
that.
I didn't want to pronounce that. So you are having problem with Muhammad, correct?
Go to Quran, never. Because Muhammad, according to Quran, whenever we go to the WC, we use water. And you here in London.
Oh, you are using water because you are in West now. Because you are in West now.
Number two. Even you don't use number two.
Where does
for
it in
your
the Quran?
Number two or for your mouth.
I am grateful and that I you came and watched when I was doing number two. You know what's happening over there.
Okay.
So tell me.
This is a false issue.
It's a false issue.
Since you are in West, so you
issue.
Started living a
sorry,
cleaning, cleanliness. You are living a clean life because you are in West.
Yes.
In your own country, yes. You should be still doing this.
So you hate my country. So you hate my country.
Huh?
Yeah, you hate the people of my country. That is fine.
Do I hate your people?
No. You speak as a racist.
I'm here. I'm here to open your ear and open your eye. I give you an insight about your
he hates the Muslims and he hates the Arabs.
We don't hate anybody.
He's not Muslim. So he's not tall.
Stupid Christian like you.
Thank you for the compliment. If I am stupid, still I am the daughter of Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever you say.
Yeah.
But because he's not a Muslim, he's not told to hate people. He's Christian. He's taught to love people like you.
No, he's shitting on Muslims. He's shitting on my country. He's shitting on everyone. You are shitting.
What happened to your love language?
The West.
No.
What happened to your love language?
I'm giving you the information which is written in your books.
You are a delinquent.
Far East. In your hadith, it is written. It's your scholar who are giving this information. It's your Muhammad who is giving this information. If I'm just presenting it, you are telling me that I hate you? No. I don't hate you.
Let me give the reference.
I still love you.
Let me give the reference how Allah expresses his love towards black people.
Yeah.
This is disgraceful.
Here we go. Look.
Listen carefully. Listen carefully.
On the day, some faces will be whiter and some will be blacker. As for those whose faces have been blackened, it will be said to them, disbelieve. You are after your belief. Then taste the punishment for that you disbelieve. You are ending up in hell because of your face color code. How do we know that? Islamic tradition tells us, and Allah struck his left Adam's left shoulder and brought forth offspring black, as they told.
No, I am Christian from my birth.
Okay, it's right over the top of his head.
No, I invite you. I invite you for Jesus. I invite you for Jesus. Love Jesus and be a follower of Christ.
To be Orthodox or Catholic?
He's a Christian.
Follower of Jesus. That's why I'm telling you.
Catholic.
That's why I'm telling you, don't be Shia, don't be Sunni, don't be Marzai, don't be...
Did you hear what she said?
Come to Jesus and follow Jesus.
Did you hear what she said?
All those who follow Jesus, there is only one and only follower of Jesus.
I'm asking the question. I don't know why did you ask the question.